So, where you been up to?
Nothing much. Lately, I'm really into going to the cinema.
Oh, which recent movie have you watched?
I have watched a few, but Beauty and the Beast was my favorite.
Really? Is it very good?
Yes, it's a musical movie.
I see. Emma Watson played as Belle and Dan Stevens played as the Beast, right?
Yes.
So, what is the story about?
The story is the same as the old one, but modernized.
I haven't watched Beauty and the Beast before.
Are you being serious? Oh God, what are you doing with your life?
Are you going to tell me or not?
Okay, just chill.
Good.
The story is about a cold-hearted prince who refuses to exchange his palace to a woman begged for a night from the storm outside with a rose. Because of that, the woman turned him into a hideous beast and his servants into objects. The enchantress then cast a spell on the rose, warning the prince that, unless he learns to love another and earn their love in future before the last petal falls, he and his servants will lose their humanity forever.
Good for him for being so bad to the poor beggar. What a good test.
True. Years later, in a nearby village of Villeneuve, a young woman named Belle lives with her father Maurice, an artist tinkerer, dreams of living life with full of adventure. One day, while on the way to a market to sell music boxes, he and his horse Philippe lost their way in the forest and entered a wolf's territory and they were attacked. They decided to enter the beast's castle to stay for the night. When Maurice tried to steal Rose from the castle, the beast saw him and arrested in the castle's prison.
Not good.
When Philip returned back to the village, Belle realized that her dad wasn't there, so she got on Philip and asked him to take her to her dad. When she arrived at the castle, she ran into the castle and found her way to the prison. The beast noticed her with her dad in the prison and she told the beast that she will take her dad's place. The beast agrees with her decision.
That's so sweet. So much love.
Belle became friends with the castle servants who treat her a spectacular dinner. After dinner, she wanders into the forbidden West Wing and finds the rose. The beast was so angry and chased her out of the West Wing that she escapes the castle into the forest. However, later, the beast rescued her from a pack of wolves. They went back to the castle and a friendship relationship between Belle and the beast was built when she helped to nurse his wound. The servants informed her that maybe she is the one who can break the curse. The beast develops feelings for Belle and allows her access to his library. He shows Belle a gift the enchantress gave him, a book that could take people wherever they wanted. Belle used it to go to Paris with the beast in an old windmill where her family used to live when she was an infant. The beast develops feelings for Belle and allows her access to his library. He shows Belle a gift the enchantress gave him, a book that could take people wherever they wanted.
That's sad, but at least she knows the truth.
Meanwhile, Maurice went back to the village and told the villagers about Belle and asked them to help him to rescue his daughter. No one believes him when he said a beast caught Belle. Gaston, a former soldier, agrees to help, but when he reveals that only agreed to help so that Maurice will allow him to marry Belle. Maurice didn't agree and in response Gaston tied him around a tree so that he will be killed by the wolves. Maurice was saved by a woman named Agathe and accuses Gaston of his crime, but Gaston convinces the townsfolk to send Maurice to the local insane asylum.
Evil Gaston, whatever his name is.
Ha ha. After having a romantic dance with the beast, Belle saw her dad is being beaten up by Gaston's people through a magic mirror. The beast let Belle go so that she could rescue her dad and the beast gave her the magic mirror so that she could remember her. At Villeneuve, Belle showed the villagers including Gaston the beast through the mirror. When Gaston feel that Belle had fallen in love with the beast, he locked her up with her in the asylum carriage. Gaston and the villagers prepared themselves to slay the beast. During an ensuing battle, Gaston abandons his companion LeFou, who sides with the servants to fend off the villagers. Gaston went up to the tower to fight the beast, but the beast is too depressed to fight back. He regained the strength to fight back when he saw Belle on the tower. He corners Gaston but didn't kill him before reuniting with Belle. However, Gaston fatally shoots the beast in the back shortly afterward. The stone bridge that Gaston is standing on collapses, causing him to fall to his death. The beast dies as the last rose petal falls and the castle's servants become completely inanimate. Then Belle confesses her love and Agatha reveals herself to be the enchantress and undoes the curse, restoring the beast's life in human form. The servants' human forms and the villagers' memories are also restored, with several villagers recognizing some of the servants as their relatives. The prince and Belle host a ball for the kingdom, where they dance happily.
What a happy ending. Now you are making me wanting to watch the movie even though I know the story.
Ha ha ha. You want me to go with you to the cinema tonight? I would love to watch the movie again.
Nah, it's okay. I am busy tonight, I will just watch it online.
Okay then. It's running late, I better go. See ya.
Yeah, me too. See ya.